I'm right here with another Q&A special from my terrace, as you can see, because I'm staying home and that's what our government wants. It's for our benefit after all. But anyway, one thing that I really want to share with you guys is that I'm feeling kind of slow today, or maybe that's how I have been this past 1 week. But this video, this particular Q&A video is my high. It totally is, because especially the Friday specials, because of its interactive format where I get to talk, we get to talk. So for those who still don't know, let me tell you what do I do in my Friday specials. So whenever you guys have any question or confusion or any sort of doubt that's related to technology, because it's always evolving. Technology is one thing that's always changing, coming up with new things. So whenever you have such doubts or confusion or questions related to technology, you guys ask me and I answer you. We discuss about it and I solve it. So yeah, but how do we do that? So whenever you have any question that you want to ask me, what you do is, it's very simple. You ask your question in the comment section of this video, or maybe on any of my Q&A videos that I do every Friday. So write down your question, use the hashtag Let's Get Techie with the question, because that's really important. And it's as simple as that. I'll take your question next Friday. So go ahead, if you also have any sort of question, ask me and I do this video every Friday and I'll take your question in the next video. That's what I was trying to say. So with that, let's begin with the video. Hi, you're watching India Today Tech. I am Pavni Jain and it's time to take today's question. So it's time to get techie. So today's first question is asked by Aditya Udhani. He writes, the OnePlus Z comes with the latest generation MediaTek processor, but is MediaTek really on par with Snapdragon and Exynos? OnePlus Z is still a rumored phone, guys, and it using a MediaTek is also a rumor. But let's just see if these rumors turn out to be true, then OnePlus could end up using MediaTek Dimensity 1000 chip. MediaTek Dimensity 1000 chip is actually on par with the Snapdragon 855 Plus chipset, Snapdragon 865 and Exynos. I won't deny that Snapdragon 865 is actually one of the most powerful chipsets we have today. But at the same time, MediaTek has got the fast CPU in Dimensity 1000. So performance may or may not be as fast as 865, but remember that OnePlus is master at optimizations and its Oxygen OS can actually bring the most and best out of it. So the best part with OnePlus Z is that you can actually get flagship performance at a mid-range price. So I'm actually looking forward to this device and let's see. What's interesting is, let's see if MediaTek can break into Qualcomm's monopoly. Next question is asked by Devashish Katoria. He writes, what are your thoughts on purchasing a Redmi phone in sub 16K price range? Redmi 9 Pro Max or Poco X2? Okay. Though Poco claims to be a different entity altogether, but what you need to understand, Devashish, is Poco X2 is a rebranded device, which was a Redmi K30 4G that was traded in China. And when it came to India, it came with a whole new different story. But anyway, it's still a Redmi's device, plus it runs on Redmi software. So whatever you choose out of these two phones, you'll end up buying a Redmi's device. But if you ask me which one is better out of these two, is it Redmi 9 Pro Max or Poco X2? I would say go ahead with Poco X2 because of its 120Hz refresh rate, slightly better chipset and 64MP quad camera system at the back, which uses a Sony image sensor and not Samsung. It is better than Redmi 9 Pro Max Samsung sensor, so you get better cameras. One important thing, so with Poco X2 you will get longer software support in comparison to Redmi 9 Pro Max as well, so go ahead with Poco X2. Time for another question. Sanjay Singh, actually these are two questions by two different people, but these are similar questions, so I'm kind of combining them. So Sanjay Singh has written, I am interested in buying a phone under 20K. Requirements are good display, good battery life, and yes, it should be compact. And Prathmesh Chaudhary has written, which phone is better, Poco X2, Realme 6 Pro, Mi A3 or Realme X2? So, okay, first one, Sanjay, if you want a very compact phone, go ahead with Realme X2. You get AMOLED display, powerful 730G chipset and 64 megapixel quad camera system with Samsung sensor. But coming to the next question, and it is also like it's a combined answer. So if you can actually compromise a little bit with the size of the phone, then Poco X2 is one of the best test devices under rupees 20,000 in the current situation, because it comes with powerful it comes with the same 64 megapixel quad camera system but with powerful Sony image sensor plus similar chipset. So yeah, depending on the size of the phone, choose either Realme X2 or Poco X2, but as per the specs and features, I would say Poco X2. Next is by Sanyam Jain. He writes, please share opinions on Asus phones in terms of longevity, as they have clean software and solid performance. Asus phones have clean software and great build quality, but latest updates take time to come on these phones. Asus now makes premium phones just like Asus 6Z. Oh my god, that was an amazing phone with that cool flip camera module. And ROG phone 2 with 120Hz refresh rate. Asus should make more phones, no? Okay, Revanth has got two questions. Number one, please suggest best smartwatch, not bands please, under 5K. Under 5K, it is difficult to get a smartwatch. Seriously, but the closest you get is the Amazfit Bip, BIP. So check that out. The next question is, in future, will we get best smartwatches under 5K, which cost around 15K now? Okay, smartwatches are premium and a niche category that not everyone wants. And it's also expensive because it's costly to manufacture, plus it also includes medical grade sensors inside a smartwatch. Vardhan Jain wants to know, please give update on OnePlus 8 and 8 Lite. OnePlus is going to launch its new 8 series on April 14. I'm really excited. Stay tuned to our website for latest updates. Next question is by Bandana Tyagi. He writes, 40,000 rupees, best phone, OnePlus, other. Very crisp question. So, crisp answer is OnePlus 70. You can also consider Samsung Galaxy S10 Lite. Next question is by Vicky Singh. He writes, which is best Samsung M31? Which is best? Samsung M31 versus Redmi Note 8 Pro. Samsung M31 for its 6000 mAh battery and AMOLED display. Today's last question is by Aman M. He writes, buying Samsung S9 Plus now for 24999 is a great idea. Full stop. Where is the question? Even if it's a statement, I disagree, because it's a very old phone. S9 Plus is a very, very old phone and it won't even get the latest One UI 2.1 software update. What is the point? But if you are looking for a new smartphone and your budget is 25K, I can suggest you something else. You can check out Redmi K20 Pro, which is Xiaomi's flagship device. Or if you're a die-hard Samsung fan, you can consider the new Galaxy A51. So consider these two phones and please forget about S9 Plus. Yes, so that's all for today's video. If you like it, give it a big fat thumbs up. Share this video with your friends. Do not forget to subscribe to India Today Tech. I come up with every new Q&A video every Friday. So stay tuned, and if you have questions, I have told you the process. Okay, you know the drill. You can ask me, shoot your question in the comment section. Use the hashtag Let's Get Techie and I'll take it next Friday. See you. Stay safe. Stay at home, please.